proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted, leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as it points the way. He don't stop to wonder why. Finds his lifelong friend just lying in the road. Well, it's a touching reunion. He sees what's left of the rippling walls, years of work undone in an instant, in the calamity. And then he falls to his death. I'm just fooling. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a gas fella, forced out from underground. Kid pops him good. Kid just rages for a while. An old repeater falls out of the sky. Ain't a gift from the gods, but it'll have to do. Gotta hold her still to spin up the chamber. Kid's worked up quite a thirst by now, so that fountain looks real inviting. Sometimes you just need a drink. A school of squirts tunnels up around him. Must have fled here from the mines. It's a wonder the old saloon's still standing. Used to have the nicest view. Kid finds a memento from a girl he knew. Always used to fancy her. He sets foot inside one of Celandia's famous watering holes. Inside's old Rondi, the bartender. The calamity got him before his drinking did. Then Kid finds his trusty shield. The security takes him for a petty thief. Special delivery. Gas, fellas. Windbags start turning up for last call. Squirts start coming out of the woodwork. A big old fella pops out in front of the kid. Them windbags are playing for keeps. Kid sees the way to the bastion out the window. It's a bit of a drop. Ronde always wanted his ashes scattered here. He gets a good look at things on his way down. He lands on top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke. Kid better watch his step. Kid spies a good perch for some target practice. He knows he should draw the string all the way back. The kid pockets a memento from a breaker, once the fastest man in the land. Good news is the emergency defenses still work. Bad news is they're aiming for the kid. Up a few pointers from a dusty old tome. He's a mighty fast learner. He finds the distillery, right next to the arsenal, the tough part of town. One sip of the spirits in that distillery, and the kid'll feel like a new man. The the arsenals where the kid can pick the best tools for the job. Some of them squirts birthing like crazy in a couple of corn bins. That one was Maud, the tutor. Once taught the kid good manners, he never used them though. An old ferry barge sends the kid on his way. The bastion's real close now. Takes a chunk of alloy, smell of barley and spoiled blueberries fills the air. Scumbags. Kid maybe shouldn't have done what he just did. Bad time to run out of black tonic. Puts him out of his misery. Robs a scumbag of his last meal. He finds the core to the wharf district. He steals the city's heart. Might as well. Kid has a feeling he better get a move on. The place is starting to fall. See, that core Kid took was the only thing making this particular rock stay afloat. Kid just keeps running. At last, the skyway is in sight. Whisks him where he needs to go. Now the kid sees something stranger still. His mind races. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds another. He finds me. We talk for a spell. I try to let the kid down gently. This is the Bastion, all right. Except no one else showed up. All I tell him is to set that core of his on the monument there, then watch. There's a bit of the Bastion's power in that crest, enough to point the way to the cores. Ain't always much to say. Kid ain't finished here yet. Just like that, the Bastion comes alive. Starts growing again, growing stronger. Kid's gotta put its power to good use. Now the Bastion can send him even farther into the wild unknown. Kid ponders what to build. Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to. Ain't much Kid can't handle with hammer and bow in hand. Kid don't know what's out there waiting for him. The Skyway. Now the kid can ride the wind to distant lands. The Workman Ward. Them windbags used to keep the city humming along here. The Wharf District. Folks sailed deep into the boundless sea from here. Now he lands at the intersection between bad and wrong. Ought to be a core down one of these twisted streets. But which one? He heads for the squirt steps. Won't be no field trip this time. He heads for the biggest dump in town. Scumbag Alley. Some scumbag still feeding off the city's own trash. And there he is. The oldest scumbag of them all. Gershel. But Calamity ain't done much for Gershel's sunny disposition. They always said old Gershel wouldn't go without a fight. The rest of the path is gone for good, and his city crest won't bring it back. No core. No surprise. Like the gas fellas are hiding it from him. Kid ain't ever seen an elephant squirt before. Hopes he'll never see one again. They say even the most rambunctious squirts can be tame. No sign of the core here. At least the kid got something for his trouble. Just about anything. Except for this. It's quick for slicing and light enough to throw. Them squirts just don't know when to quit. Squirts don't make the best of friends, but they can be useful in a pinch. Up north is where the gas fella foreman used to live, tending to his flock. Know why gas fellas all dress alike. Kids wondering the same thing. And there it is, but it's locked down tight in an alloy cage. Lustery old foreman's keeping his fellas in check, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. And now there's a new marshal in town. has the whole place grown, but it's too tough to fall. Might as well check the other side streets before leaving this hole. He heads for the east side, where windbags used to keep the local forge. Somehow that old forge is still standing. Odd place to find the lights of Percy the Snitch. Inside the forge, Key can fine-tune those instruments of his. Kid's lifelong friends looking fit to keep on fighting. With a good length of meat gut, that bow's like new again. The little Zolwood oil on that blade shines like a light. Kid's ready to go, and his ticket out's right where he started. He comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack, the monument's calling for it. The windbags used to be all right, then the calamity took the floor out from under him. Sometimes a single look says it all. Can't be too careful these days. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. Makes time to sample spirits from my personal supply. swear whiskey has no scent, but tastes like a peppered boot heel. It's not for everyone. Picked up traces of other cores while the kid was out. The Melting Pot. Place hoarded all sorts of fineries from beyond the boundless sea. In better days, the Melting Pot was sealed tighter than the skin on a squirt. Of all the plans to survive the calamity, it had to be Stabweed's. If there's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down. Core stuck inside one of those fancy cages. No breaking a cage like that, but the kid tries anyway. Gotta find a way to spring it open. Some of the stuff lying around was downright dangerous. He throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong? Quite a bit, as it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Not every squirt's born bad. Some spring to the kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers. Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard it pop that mean old foreman. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes. Maybe 30. Hard to tell. Squirts get real territorial around the core. Then a shipment of free samples shows up. One thing's for sure, that cage is awful heavy. Troublesome scene, to be sure. It ain't all bad. As the kid finds some spices from the motherland. Tax-free. 10, 9, 8, 7. You give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done.
She's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge. I still remember the look on his face after that one. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here.